So today we continue our discussion of regular operations and regular expressions. First, I would like to make a correction of the way I defined the A star last time. So the A star, I defined it like something like x1, x2, and it was unlimited. In fact, it shouldn't be like this. It should be x1, x2, and you should make it clear that each string in the language is going to have a certain length, k. It's going to be finite. And I'm going to explain this in a minute. So it's all strings x1, x2, xk, where k is greater than or equal to 0. Greater than or equal to 0. And each xi belongs to A. So this is slightly different than the definition that I gave last. Last time I gave a definition without a limit or a string length. So let me explain this idea. And when you define a string, each string must have a finite length. You don't have a string. When you do something like this, which is what I did last time, I was wrong, you are saying that the string can be of infinite length. A string cannot be of infinite length. A string must have a finite length, but the length is unlimited. So this is a subtle point. Each valid string has a finite length. But the length of a string is not limited, so you can accept an arbitrarily long string. Which then implies that the number of strings that you will have in this language is infinite, because you are not setting a limit on the string length. Each string has a finite length, but you are not setting a limit on the length of that string. To make it more concrete and related to actual programming and compilers. In compilers, how do we use this in compilers? In fact, as you will see, when we later talk about compilers, the compiler is going to view the whole program as a string, no matter how long. So if you have a program that consists of millions of lines of code, the compiler is going to view it as a string of characters. Now, the compiler can process a program only if that program has a finite length. In fact, there is no program. You cannot write a program that has an infinite length, because you'll have to write it. So any program that is written by human beings within the lifetime of a human being, it's going to have finite length. So the compiler can process a program, processes programs with finite lengths, but there is no limit on the length of that program. So did you ever try to compile a program, a very long program, with a compiler, and the compiler said, this program is too long for me to compile? No. The compilers that I'm aware of do not have this limitation. At least, the algorithms, the compiler algorithms, there may be some limitation on the resources. I mean, the compiler is trying to compile a program that is too large, may exhaust system resources like memory or whatever, but that's a different story. You know, the compiler itself, the algorithms in the compiler are designed to accept an arbitrarily long program. Okay, so this is the idea, the right definition of X, of the star operation. And it's important to pay attention to these subtleties. Now let's review regular expressions by giving a couple of examples on regular expressions before we move to the main topic of today's lecture, which is closure properties of regular languages. So let me give you this. Last time, we gave the language, and then I asked you to figure out the regular expression. Now I give you the regular expression, and I ask you to figure out the language. What about this regular expression. Of course, you know, remember, sigma is any one symbol, and sigma star is any what?
Any
string.
Including the empty string.
Yeah, any string including the empty string. Okay, now what language does this regular expression generate? Multiples of three. Okay, what's the multiple of three? So give me a more precise description of the language. What should be, what quantity should be a multiple of three? What quantity? The length of the string. The length of the string is the quantity that is a multiple of three. So we have to be specific. L, we have to be precise here. W is the set of strings W such that the length of W is a multiple of 3. By the way, if you write something like W such that W is a multiple of 3. This is incorrect. Because W is a string, it's not a quantity. It's not a number. W is a string, not a number. The length of W is a number. It's a quantity. It's a multiple of 3. Okay? So in language descriptions, we have to be very precise. Okay, so we figured this out. So let me give you this. I like 3, so let's do this. So what's the language here that is generated by this?
It has at least 3 symbols?
Yeah, it's the set of strings that consists of 3 or more symbols, or the length of the string that belongs to this language is greater than or equal to 3. Okay, so such that the length of W is greater than or equal to 3. Or another way of saying it, W consists of 3 or more symbols. These are two different ways of describing the language, but both are precise and clear. But make sure that when you say that something is greater than 3 or less than 3, you're talking about a quantity or a number. Okay, so these are two examples, just to refresh your memory. Let's now give some examples of languages and try to figure out the regular expressions. Language W such that each symbol in sigma appears at least once in W. W is a string in which each symbol in the alphabet appears at least once. Or another way of saying it is that there is at least one occurrence of every symbol in the alphabet. There is at least one occurrence of every symbol in the alphabet. Okay? Now, of course, we cannot answer this question without knowing what the alphabet is. So the alphabet here is going to be A, B. Now for this alphabet, how would you write a regular expression for this? Okay, so we have A, B, right? And
sigma stars.
Yeah, the sigma stars, right. Yeah. Sorry, it's my fault.
But we also need a or, because what if B comes before A?
Sorry. Yeah, I was thinking in something else. So that, yeah. So thank you for the correction. Yeah, so it's A, B, and, you know, before, after, between, you can have anything. And B, then A, you can have anything. Now, what about this? W such that W starts and ends with the same symbol. W starts and ends with the same symbol. How would you do this? What's the regular expression for this?
You would have A, then any symbol starred, and then B, or, and then you just have the mirror image of that. So B, any image starred, A.
Starts and ends with the same symbol.
Oh, no, I meant, I should have said A starts then A, or B, any symbol B.
Yeah, I think you said A, but I screwed up, I think. It's
no, I totally said the wrong thing.
Okay. So it starts and ends with the same symbol. A, sigma star A, B, sigma star B. So if you give this answer in the test, you will get 9 out of 10 or 8 out of 10. Why? Because it's missing something. What is it missing?
Yes.
It's not covering all the strings that satisfy this property.
One thing,
is
it if it's blank? Yeah.
What's that?
If it's blank?
No, blank doesn't start and end with the same symbol. Yeah? Yes? Anyone? What should we add?
Empty string?
What's that? Epsilon doesn't start and end with the same symbol because it doesn't even start. It doesn't start at all. So what are the strings that start and end with the same symbol but are not covered by this?
The strings of length 1.
Yeah, the strings of length 1. A by itself or B by itself. So make sure that you cover all the corner cases. So here you have A by itself or B by itself. Okay, so this is a corner case or a special case that you need to cover. So this is the strings that are of length 2 or greater that start and end with the same symbol. Start and end with the same symbol of length 2 or greater. And this is the string with one symbol that starts and ends with the same symbol. Okay? So I think we have enough examples now to clarify the idea of the regular expressions, and I think now we are ready to do the homework.